listeners, I hope you all are safe at your home, right? This is our last lecture of chapter number 7, Diversity of Living Organism. I will give you a quick review about the diversity of living organism. Still you have problem, then you can ask me friendly. Okay, we had started our 7th chapter or diversity of living organism from the classification, right? What is the meaning of classification? Classification means we had classified the living organism into the various category on the basis of their function. And for the simplification, to understand the different type of animals and their character simply. So we had classified the living organism into 5 category. This is called 5 kingdom classification, which is given by Whittaker. This is the scientist who gave the 5 kingdom classification. And this classification of living organism is most accepted classification. We had divided the living organism on the 5 classes: Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae, and Animalia. What are Monera? They have unicellular prokaryotes. Who are unicellular prokaryotes? Means bacteria. Bacteria are present in that class only in Monera. What is the function of bacteria? Bacteria are prokaryotic, so their nucleus does not consist nuclear membrane. Simply, nuclear membrane is absent in case of Monera. So they are not called true bacteria. They are false. Their nucleus is false. Pseudo kind of membrane, you can say that membrane is absent. So false nucleus is present in case of Monera. They reproduce by binary fission or multiple fission simply, right? And they reproduce by various methods, by the if sexual reproduction, if we will discuss about the sexual reproduction in bacteria, bacteria also show sexual reproduction and asexual reproduction by binary fission and multiple fission. Next is the protista. Protista are the kingdom where the unicellular prokaryotes are present. All the protozoans are present in that kingdom. Unicellular eukaryotes. Eukaryotes means whose nucleus is true type. True type means nuclear membrane is present in their nucleus simply. So all the protista, unicellular protista, diatoms and dinoflagellates, euglena, all are present in the protista simply. Next is the fungus. Fungus are the fungus consist unicellular or multicellular but eukaryotic organism. They have special structure, fiber like structure is called hyphae, which help for the absorption of nutrient and water from the soil. And they does not perform photosynthesis because they does not have chlorophyll molecules. They depend for the feeding on dead organic matter, so they are called saprophytes. One more important point about the fungus is their cell wall is made up of a complex sugar is called chitin, and they have capability to make a lichen or symbiotic association with the algae, green algae. They make a association with the algae and form the lichens. Next are our plantae. Plantae have special character because they have a pigment, green color pigment, which is called chlorophyll. And due to this chlorophyll, they have capability to synthesize their own food in the presence of sunlight, CO2. You know that photosynthesis simply. You know that about the process of photosynthesis. So they have capability of photosynthesis. Plantae are further divided into various classes simply: Thallophyta, Bryophyta, Pteridophyta, Gymnosperm and Angiosperm. Out of these, Thallo, Bryo and Pteridophyta are the cryptogames. Cryptogames means they do not have seeds and flowers. Seeds and flowers are absent in that cases. And these two are phanerogames. It means seeds and flowers and fruits are present in Gymnosperm and Angiosperm. Thallophyta means algae. They does their structure, their body structure is kind of thallus. Thallus means there is no differentiation of root, stem and leaf. We cannot differentiate between root, stem and leaf. So these are called thallophyta. But because they have green pigment chlorophyll and perform photosynthesis, so this is the class of plantae, kingdom plantae. they does not have any kind of vascular bundle. Xylem and phloem is absent, completely absent in Thanophyta. Xylem and phloem is present in Bryophyta but not well developed. These are called amphibians of plant kingdom. Why they are called amphibians? Because they have capability to survive in aquatic or what you can say that water as well as terrestrial area. So they are called amphibians of plant kingdom. Pteridophyta have vascular bundles, but not completely, but instead of Bryophyta they have developed vascular bundles and they are completely terrestrial. But all these three does not produce seeds and fruit, simply they divide by the spores only. Spores are produced which spread with the help of air and they germinate into the new plant body. Next are the gymnosperm and angiosperm. Gymnosperm have seeds but naked seeds. You cannot see these seeds with your eyes. They are very small sized of seeds. They perform photosynthesis. They have also capability of sexual reproduction. They have flower also. They produce fruits. Similarly, angiosperms are the flowering plants. Beautiful flower, colored flowers are present in case of angiosperm, and seeds are also present. Food is also present. Their seeds are of two type, monocots and dicots. Monocot, in which one leaf is present, and dicot, it means their seed consists two leaves, right? This is all about the planting. Next is the animalia. Animals are divided into two categories. First is the non-chordates and next are the chordata. Non-chordate means which do not have a notochord or vertebral column are called non-chordate. These all are the non-chordate: Porifera, Coelenterata, Platyhelminths, Nematoda, Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata. They do not have notochord. Notochord is absent in that cases. Further, chordata are divided into two categories: protochordata and vertebrata. Vertebrata have four classes: pisces, amphibia, reptile, aves, and mammalia. I will give you a quick review. Porifera, which have pores. Coelenterata, which have capability to bioluminescence, produce light in the water. Platyhelminths, they have flat structure. Nematoda, they are rounded, round worms, right? So they are called roundworm because they have round structure. Annelida, their body consists ribs. Body is divided into small segments. Arthropoda, paired appendages is present. Mollusca, soft body covered by a shell. Echinodermata, body consists spine-like structure. Spines are present. So these are the points which I discuss with you today are the important point of that kingdom. Instead of these, you can write triploblastic, or bilateral symmetry and coelomate or non-coelomate. These are the common points you need to write, but these are the point I told you are the important point of this phylum. Simply you can say that, which are present only in that phylum, not any other phylum. So these points are the important point. Instead of these points, you can see you can write the common points, how the cellular level of organization or other level of organization, what kind of excretion they do, what type of circulatory system, open or closed, what type of circulatory system is present. These are the common points which you need to learn simply. Next are our chordata. Chordata are the animals which have chordate or notochord or vertebral column is present, which are divided into two parts. Chordates have nerve cord, gill slits. These are the common point of chordate. Protochordate and vertebrata. Protochordate are not completely chordata because they have notochord, but this notochord is not present in the entire life. It means notochord is present only in the embryonic stage, when the baby is small. Simply you can say that only in embryonic stage, not in adult state. Adult means like this, not present in adult state. So they are called protochordate. It means they are chordate but not they are the previous chordate. After this, the vertebrata arise. Vertebrata, they have notochord in all the stages, vertebrata as well as embryonic as well as adult stage. These vertebrata further divided into five classes. Pisces, fish is completely aquatic, cartilage and bony type of fishes. They have fins for the movement. They have streamlined body. they have two chambered of heart. Next is the amphibia. They are they survive in both water as well as terrestrial area. They have two complete chamber, and third chamber is partially developed, not completely. Third chamber is present, and they respire with the lungs as well as lungs, because they have both type of respiratory system. Their skin is moist type of consists of mucus gland. Next is the reptilia. They are completely terrestrial, not present in the aquatic area. They have three chambered, completely developed, but fourth is partially developed. Exception in the crocodile. Crocodile have four completely chambered. Four chambers of heart are completely developed, and their skin are dry. All these are egg-laying. All these are egg-laying animals. It means oviparous. They lay the egg, and from the egg, young one is produced. Right. And next are the apes. Apes like birds, which have feathers, beaks, ovaries. One ovary is absent, you know that. And simply, they are also oviparous. All these three species, amphibia and reptilia, are cold-blooded. Cold-blooded means which have capability to change their internal body temperature according to the external environment. But apes and mammalia are warm-blooded animals, which do not change their internal temperature. They change in their body to maintain their internal temperature, like during summer sweating maintain their body temperature. During winter we will shiver, right? Shivering generally generate heating so that our internal body temperature maintain. Mammalia means mammary glands are present, hairs are present, right? They are viviparous, directly produce young ones. Example is the platypus and echidna. They are egg-laying mammals. They produce eggs. And shark is a fish, but because it produces direct young ones, so it is classified in the mammalia, not in the fishes. Fishes is not include shark, because shark is a viviparous and fishes are the oviparous. So shark is present in the mammalia. So this is all about the five kingdom classification. One small topic is the nomenclature. As the name indicate, nomenclature means naming to anyone. All the plants and the animals have their scientific name. The given their specific name or a scientific name is called nomenclature, right? For example, I will give you human being, Homo sapiens. This is the name of human being. This is the genus. This is the species. The first letter of genus is always should be capital, and the first letter of species is always should be small letter. There is no comma, and full stop and hyphen should be present between the genus and species. Or both the genus and species, if you handwritten in your notebook or book, then it should be underlined properly, separately. There is no mixing of the underline. There is a separation of the underline between the genus and the species. So this is the nomenclature, because one living organism have two name. One is the genus name and another is the species name. So this nomenclature is called binomial nomenclature. Bi means two, nomial means name. Two name, which is called scientific name of any plant, animal, bacteria, any, is called nomenclature, binomial nomenclature. That is all about the diversity of living organism. Your chapter number 7 has been completed today. Thank you, 9th class.